Oh, it's all at the same time. When I prepare the presentation, they're kind of like, one by one. Okay. So, there's a paradox when we teach fillers. That is, how can you consciously teach something that should be used unconsciously? Think about that for a moment. So, it's like, hello? When we teach fillers, students tend to speak like this. So I was walking home, and you know, then I saw my friend, well. So it should be like natural instead of robotically added to your oral discourse. And something that happens with Portuguese speakers is that they tend to add an extra syllable to words such as but that they pronounce when they're taking time to think, they're gonna say butty. This is called the Brad Pitt phenomenon. There's a name for this. Because Brazilians call him Brady Pitty. Yeah, so I didn't invent this. It was a YouTuber. So they're gonna say butty MD. And this is something people don't usually correct. Like, what you should prolong is but, and then there's a final sound, and. So we came up with an activity to practice the use of fillers. Kind of nervous. That was like, they would have to present 30 seconds of nothing, just feeling. The beginning of a presentation, that the climax would be nothing. So it would work more or less like this. So I'm gonna talk about that's right. You know, right? That's done. That's the activity. So they should do this as naturally as possible. And I think it was successful. My coworkers can tell that it did work. Woo-hoo! Fine. Yeah. So I think this is just one way that we can practice the use of fillers instead of just, right there, U-H. Yeah, so they can actually speak it, yeah? The second part is about the question time moment. When speaking in public, there's always a question time. Probably there are going to be some questions here. I see Boris already rushing for the microphone.
Russian.
Jesus.
Is Russian. That was a stupid joke.
Sorry for the pun. It's important to be formal and not rude when receiving a question. You can dismiss questions like, I'm gonna talk about this again. Brazilians tend to be very direct when speaking. Whereas English isn't a direct language. So this is something that should be adapted. Yeah. I have here some samples that I would like you guys to work together. Can you say hello to the person next to you?
Hello.
That's it. Okay. Preferably someone you don't know. Someone you don't know. So choose one here. You shouldn't say these things. Okay, this is incorrect. So together, I'm going to give you a minute. Try to make these longer and actually polite. Could you do this? Yeah? So go.
Ask me questions.
Like simultaneously. Start speaking there, start speaking there, go.
It's bare word.
Bare word or trio. Yeah.
Think about your students when you ask them to do
like,
bare word.
Pardon me, I think I have already answered.
Go.
I have the feeling that I have already answered that before.
Good.
The other people aren't interested in your question. Maybe they didn't understand.
Yeah, good.
I'll never finish if they are more thorough. Would you please leave your questions for the end of the presentation?
Yeah.
Like a gentleman. So now I'd like you guys to share how you have transformed.
Could the fourth, I can.
Someone. One volunteer. I don't want to cold call anyone.
Okay.
Sandra, can you cold call someone?
Okay, I always got volunteers around here. So, volunteers.
Eu ainda tenho que segurar o microfone. Né?
Could you ask me one more question, please?
Do you guys agree?
Yes. Yeah.
Round of applause. I was just kidding.
Okay.
You want now number two.
Do you have another volunteer here?
Of course.
Would you kindly present the questions?
Now another one.
I guess that the question has been previously given a proper answer.
Like Shakespeare.
Wow.
like a true boss, man.
Okay.
Which one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
The last one.
The last one?
Yeah, I didn't rewrite information. I just got the information. Like, guys, let's focus. Write down your questions, you know, on the top or the bottom of your books, and then we, at the end of the class, we can talk about it.
All right. So this case, like speaking to a group of students.
Yeah, because we're talking about bigger interruptions, and that happens, you know.
In class.
Yeah. So we need to focus, you know, and keep on the track. Which, you know, interruptions sometimes are necessary.
Yeah, but here I was like teaching students how to speak in public. It's not like teacher to student, but when the student has a presentation.
Okay, so I got wrong.
So like me, imagine I say this. So guys, I'll never finish if there are more interruptions. How would you correct me in this case speaking to you guys?
I think we could save questions for later, so that we can focus now on the main topic.
You have plenty of time to ask questions later.
So I'll never finish there. More interruptions. That will be. I guess we can, save questions for later, and so that we can focus on the main topic. That will be my way of addressing.
Cool. Thanks for your participation. Okay, now I'm going to do some things wrong. So, and then you have to tell me what I'm doing wrong. Okay?
Okay.
I haven't started yet. Okay, so I'm just gonna, speak about a bunch of nonsense.
Okay.
So this presentation today will be about the importance of flamingos in the fauna of Senegal. What am I doing?
Eye contact.
You know, eye contact and body language. Clothes like this.
That's right. Next one. So guys, do you have any more questions now? Can we eat some more croissants? Any more questions? Yeah, sounding bored, right? Okay. Let me see if I remember the next one. Okay, also the next one is right here.
Not prepared.
You're reading.
Yes.
Exactly. Because, like the philosopher Lao Tzu once said, I'll leave you with that for a moment. What's wrong there?
It's in Chinese.
Yes, I'm saying something like in a different language, I'm not explaining what it is. And what else? Sorry, this one is actually, I forgot. Okay, so, guys, you're here today to talk about the new methodology, and we have 3 points. The first one, what am I doing?
Rushing.
Giving me panic. Giving me afraid.
Yeah, the correct answer would be like lots of gestures, but I guess aggressiveness may be right as well. Yeah, my name is Scorza, so I have to sound Italian. But of course, nothing that I said can be taken under consideration because it may all be wrong. I don't know. Who am I? Yeah, so contradicting yourself. And at the end, there is the use of humor. The use of humor may or may not be wrong because I guess it depends on the audience. Yeah. You have to feel the audience. So today, I decided to do something, you know, more formal without so much humor.
Did you?
Yeah, I was going to ask him that.
Yeah, I suffer from my use of humor most of the time. I usually use
and that's it.
Why am I glad?
Woohoo!
Guys, I guess there was a nice change of path in the center of my head. Because I just remember your last name, Scorza.
Yes, that's it.
But the first one.
Alvaro,
I just remember Scorza.
So now let's talk about how basic one students have been resisting.
No, it's not this. I guess we can always come back to this topic, but it was an interesting change of path on the way Mr. Scorza, in a polite way, got something from the book, which is the second part of the we start with coaching and then we move to public speaking, and brought his experience in the classroom and shared with us something that he built upon the book, which is something that I really, and that would be no, this is real. I watched the presentation, which is very simple, but at the same time, it was built upon the book with something personal from a teacher at a school. Whenever that things happen, it really makes sense why we write books. We write books because of this. Thank you, Scorza.
No, thank you.
Thank you for building upon the book, for using the book as just the beginning of what can be done in the classroom. It strikes me that sometimes we, of course, that we understand that there are difficulties that students resist and this and that. But when, I'm more than open to answer all questions. But then when there is a presentation that takes something that you wrote there and took it to your own personal experience as a teacher and you thought about it, and it's true that Brazilians, we end up on the next vowel, that's what we do. I think, and that's so much true, isn't it? Instead of making the vowel that already exists longer, well, I think, yeah. And then that was something that it takes lots of classroom attention to bring these elements. And also, it brings this sense of partnership of a teacher who used the book made the book his.
Yeah, sometimes it can be difficult. After all, we're dealing with people, but when things go right, it's a very rewarding feeling.
Yeah, and then whenever teachers make books theirs, students they feel that it's built for them, because the teachers are the ones who knows the students. Teachers are the ones who know the students. They are there. So whenever they bring these elements and they create these impersonifications of the mistakes of what not to do, and they make it so real that the classroom becomes just, you know, what it is. It's natural. And then I don't think there is resistance, because the teachers really, they make the book there.
So I guess it's an example of a teacher who just made, it's not a book that I'm using, it's my book, and I made the topic mine, and I own it, and I present it. So again, I'd like to thank you, really, for your presentation, for bringing your insights.
It was a pleasure.
And bringing your ideas to everybody. And then whenever we come back to teaching public speaking, I guess we can all bring these ideas of what not to do and, creating these characters and having people laugh and creating these activities and making it your classroom, not just an activity you are running because it's there, all right? So I guess that's the message that I will take from this presentation. Make any activity of the book yours. Really, swallow it and make it, digest it, and bring it to the students with this lively attitude that Mrs. Corson brought to us. Thank you again. All right, would you like to say something, guys? Karin would like to say something.
I just wanted to comment on especially hearing the but something that we even talk about on the final exam, one of the questions.